Shipwrecks have always held an incredible fascination for divers. Metal and wood skeletons shrouded in mystery and offering the thrill of real danger. Now, they've also become a focus for scientists. They want to monitor how the wreck environment changes over time. It almost seems as if nature is trying to show us something, that it can turn scrap into a paradise. Some wrecks are like busy metropolises, covered in corals and inhabited by hordes of fish. They're like islands of life in the great blue expanse of the sea, offering food and shelter to countless animals. These insights are now going to help revive the waters off the French Mediterranean coastline. Extensive stretches of these coastal waters are biologically dead. They've turned into underwater deserts, killed by pollution and overfishing. It has given rise to one of the most important conservation projects in the Mediterranean, a huge artificial reef right in the Bay of Marseille. Sandrine Ruiton of the Université de la Méditerranée is the project's scientific advisor. Huge steel frames have been dumped in the sea just off the coastline. They are the foundations for this city of the sea. They are invisible from the surface, so to visit them, it is necessary to don diving equipment. Due to the currents and the sandy substrate, visibility underwater tends to be bad. Sandrine has to approach these artificial reefs at close range in order to see anything. Between the steel girders, different structures provide shelter for fish of all sizes. It may look unspectacular now, but first evaluations show that life is beginning to return. Plants and microorganisms have already begun to settle on the steel frames. Now, the first fish are following these pioneers. Sandrine discovers a fishing net that has become caught up in the reef. It is a poignant reminder that some fishermen don't take notice of the fishing ban in force around the artificial reef site. This is a prohibited area for hobby divers as well as fishermen. Any disturbance to the delicate new ecosystem is to be avoided. Many factors influence the success or failure of the project: currents, depth, and the structure of the components. Sandrine Ruiton documents the developments in minutest detail. The most important step was to set up sewage treatment works for the cities along the coastline. No one knows how many years it will take, or even if it will be possible at all. But there is hope that life will return to these waters in all its glory. There are also studies at other places in the Mediterranean into how the local fauna and flora can be protected and rebuilt. Pollution and overfishing have taken their toll right across the region. Just off the island, Port-Cros, there is another more modest study. This study has shown scientists how the size of an artificial reef really matters, and that the time it takes for these complex ecosystems to rebuild themselves is considerable. The scale of time needed can be seen at the wreck site of the Donator. This ship sank almost 70 years ago and lies at a depth of 50 meters just off the island of Poquerolles. Its dimensions are impressive, 80 meters long and 12 meters wide, with an open storage hold and many still intact details. The Donator was a freighter that ran on a mine after the end of World War II. It lies at the bottom of a channel between two islands, and the constant currents here are the basis for the colorful life found in and around the wreck. Artificial lights reveal the stunning colors which would otherwise remain hidden in the blue depths. Everywhere on this dead ship, there is life. The ship's sides look almost like a blossoming underwater garden. Massive sea fans thrive everywhere. They filter food from the water, which is pushed through their fan-like structures by the currents. Swarms of sea perches and breams hover above the deck. Some of the deck structures are mere skeletons. They are ideal living quarters for many organisms that can find shelter and footholds here, as only rocks could normally offer them. The tragedy of this shipwreck has turned into the fascinating story of newly colonized living space. If the artificial reefs just off Marseille and other places could turn into something comparable, it would be an incredible success. The next decades will be crucial.